If you have used small multiples before in Power BI, you probably realize that you need to hardcode the number of rows and columns, which is insane to me. Which means when you pick something from a slicer, if the number of categories is less than the ones that you selected hardcoded, you will get blanks. You will see clearly on what I'm showing you here. Absolutely hate it. So I found a workaround that works very, very well. So let me show you how I start. Okay, so how do we create this? Well, I'm going to actually do a copy of this page. I'm going to delete this one and recreate it again so you'll see. So you can recreate the data that you want in the custom, in the normal visual, in the stacked column chart. And then once you have it, you go here, you go to get more visuals, and you need to get this visual created by Microsoft. So your team or your admin should not be able to have a problem letting you install this. For the first one is certified, for the second is just created by Microsoft. So Microsoft has already your data. You're using Power BI, so use it. So you click install it, and you will get this icon. Click on the icon. And as you can see now, it's giving us a year, and then by row is giving us the operating system. We don't want it by row, we want it by column. And there you have it. I mean, it's as easy as that. We're gonna clean this up. There is a edit button in here that allows you to tweak with how the actual visualization looks, but there's also some settings here on the formatting pane. Don't forget that. And here you have these small multiples. We're going to pick the matrix, so it looks a little bit more like the original one from, you know, Power BI. It will just, you know, separate them in like boxes. Then we're going to show the header, yes. I'm going to have it a little bolder, maybe, like that, and a little bit bigger. Beautiful. And then I am going to get rid of the y-axis. I don't want it. So as you can see, I mean, the thing, it does look like, but we need to have data labels. And I'm gonna show you how you get them. So you go to the edit button and then expand it so you actually can see something. And here you have layers of, how do you say, of visualization items, if you would say. So the shape zero is the rectangular. We're going to add a new layer on top of it. And this is going to be for text. You can see that it shows text, text, text in there. We're going to put it in the middle. And then the text, this thing, it means that you can bind to a field on that you have in your visualization. In this case, we're going to bind it to units. And we're going to have zero decimal places, click apply, and then you will see that you get the numbers. Quite cool. We're going to, one thing that you need to know is that what looks small here is not that small. So if I go here to back to report and close in here, you see that the numbers were not that small as it looked. So you need to be careful not to make them too big before you actually check how big they are. We want to have them a little bit bigger than that. So again, edit and edit. We're going to, I don't know, put 14 maybe. And I don't want it under, I want it over. So to do that, so you see this orange line? It's basically tell you where the text is placed. Is it here on layout? So if we pick here minus, I think 20 pixels should work. You can test this and see how well it works. You see that the orange thing got a little bit higher. That means that those are the boundaries for the text shape or the layer. And now you can see that we have the text right outside the actual rectangle. So we go to format, and then we're going to put it, I don't know, like bold maybe. We've already done it a little bit bigger. Back to report. And look at that, so cool. One of the things that I love about this visual when it comes to data labeling is that you see that it says thousands. Let me show you another one. maybe Asia Pacific has a better example. Here, you can see that it's 2 million, 1 million, and 200,000. It does the data formatting correctly. If you look here at how Power BI does it, it does by default 0.2 instead of 200,000, which it makes no sense. I wish that Power BI had that option that if it's millions, you put it in millions, if it's thousands, you put it on thousands, and yeah, you know. But anyhow, okay, the colors. We go back and edit, make it big so you can see something. So to change the colors of the bars, you need to first go to the layer that represents the bars, which is not text, it's shape. You can see that the orange thing changed to the rectangle. And you see value color of, I'm going to turn it on. And then this thing, again, it means that you can bind to data. It's the same as chart calculator. You can then bind it to the operating system, apply, and there you have the colors. You can either take what they suggest you, or you can pick another one as you choose. Back to report, close it here. And now we have our beautiful dynamic small multiples. Yay, how cool is that? Okay, I am going to show you more visualization types for this visual. It's just amazing. There is one but though, and one of the things that I haven't been able to use it as much as I want to, it means that it doesn't support field parameters. And if I'm using field parameters on my report, I'm out of luck. This is not possible to use. So hopefully they will updated so we can continue using it. It's just brilliant.